That's a bear butt. Let's talk about Hank the Tank, a chunky bear who has been causing mayhem everywhere that he goes. This is a bear that since last July has broken into at least 28 homes in and around the Tahoe Keys area. He's described as extremely food habituated, which is how I've been described by people before. Hank has also caused extensive property damage in over 30 documented cases. I mean, look at him. If he were to just sit on anything, he would cause property damage, not to judge. Local residents have filed at least 102 police reports about this specific bear. Now, why is he doing this? Why doesn't he just go in the woods? Well, a California Department of Fish and Wildlife spokesperson, Peter Tira, says it's easier to find leftover pizza than to go in the forest. And I think we can all agree that's true. That's basically how I live my life. They've tried to stop him. They've tried to stop his crime spree. They've used a combination of deterrents, including loud sirens, dry firing their tasers, which create a clicky clack noise that bears hate. Beanbag rounds. They're treating this bear like it's a leftist protest. Back off, everybody. He's just eating pizza. Anyway, none of that has proved successful. And he apparently has lost all fear of people. It's a potentially dangerous situation. And again, we've all been there. You get loaded up on Doritos and leftover pizza and you lose all fear of your fellow man.
Yeah, I hope they don't hurt him. Like, he's just trying to eat, I guess. I mean, he's obviously causing a lot of damage and destruction. But I mean, it also is concerning that he's been eating our food and he's blown up to, you know, unbear-like proportions. So what does that say about what we are consuming? I mean, it's not anything new. It's not that like we don't know that our food is laden with all kinds of junk, but this poor bear, you know, he didn't ask for that. He didn't know about high fructose corn syrup, you know.
Exactly. And soon his skeleton might not be able to bear the weight. But anyway, he's a big guy. And look, it's garbage. It's leftover food. That said, obviously, if you're, you know, a property owner, you do not want any bear rummaging around your part, your building, let alone the biggest bear that we've ever seen. I love that, by the way, the photo that we keep showing you of Hank the Tank is credited to something called Bear League, which I think is like, is that a competitor to Dragon Squad? The Bear League. I need to look into this. But anyway, I have an idea, and understand, I know nothing about anything, especially bears and how you corral them or whatever. If you want to move him and he loves food, put some sedatives in the food or something. Like, take some sausage.
Yeah, have they not tried that yet?
Maybe they have. Maybe he can't be
sedated. Something they should have tried, you know?
You would think. Anyway,
but then you have to move a 500-pound bear. And then how do you do that? You
know? That's tough. Well, with him, I would say start rolling. He'll probably turn over. Yeah. But anyway, they acknowledge that he did not get this big eating berries and grubs. This is, you know, what our food does to people. Why not bears if they have an unlimited supply? But look at how much it can change you. They believe that the fact that he kept breaking into homes throughout the winter shows that he's not going to hibernate anymore. We have artificially created an environment where there is food always for him. So his like fundamental bear behavior is no longer happening that way anymore. Isn't that crazy how we can manipulate nature in that way just by like having ringdings around?
It kind of makes me sad. I have a very idealistic idea of what nature should be and the world should be in that respect. So yeah, it makes me a little sad that he's not hibernating. I don't know. Yeah. Which seems like the wrong reason to be sad in this case, I'll admit.
But. Exactly. But you look at that picture and you just think,
how did this happen?
Is this why I'm this way? Because I probably have a worse diet than that bear. Like, he's probably picky. Anyway.
Yeah.
And he walks around, he commits crimes. I don't even have the energy to break in to a house. Anyway.
Well, he's got a lot of strength behind him. So it's probably not that hard for him, you know?
He's a thick criminal. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.